Good morning, LaSalle. I'm Colin Friday, and this is Friday on Friday. Now let's get to today's news. Today is a B-day on our cycle, and we're on an assembly schedule, which means that classes will be shortened today due to today's award assembly. A reminder to all seniors, you must be in homeroom this Monday to pick out colleges for college interview day. If you do not pick them, college counseling may pick them for you. So to get the most out of the day, show up and get your picks in. Additionally, any senior who is on Kairos 3799, your permission form is due today in Ministry and Service Office. Finally, the Student Council Dance is coming up next Friday. Tickets will be on sale in the Dean of Students Office beginning on Tuesday. More importantly, though, is that you cannot buy tickets for girls here. If you want to bring your girlfriend or want your friend who's a girl to come, they have to order their tickets online with a credit card. Tickets for girls can go on sale tomorrow at 9 a.m. at www.lchs.org/mixer. There is a cap on the amount of tickets sold, so I would suggest you tell them to get them sooner rather than later. That's today's major headlines at school. I personally suggest that everyone goes and views full daily bulletin either in their email inbox or on a digital signage machine around campus. Finally here, we head to sports.
Welcome to LaSalle, fellas.
We get to close here what has been an absolutely brilliant week in LaSalle sports. To kick things off, on Sunday, LaSalle Rugby came in first place in the Doylestown Sevens tournament. Yet again, proving that even when it's not rugby season, rugby players are still kicking butt. This is the first of hopefully 8 Sevens tournaments that LaSalle Rugby will be participating in. Their schedule can be found on the website. The next team to strike fear into the hearts of many was the LaSalle Varsity Soccer Squad. They defeated Conwell Egan in a double overtime thriller, 1-0 on Monday. This is their fifth win of the season, and they have not had a loss in 4 consecutive matches, knock on wood. They will be taking on McDevitt at 3:45 p.m. today. Come out and support the team. Additionally, cross country finished up 4th in the Briarwood Invitational. Golf picked up another win yesterday with a 24-stroke win over Germantown Academy, and the water polo team will compete in the Beast of the East tournament. Finally, we finish up with the football team. The football team is coming off quite the close matchup against DeMatha High School in a win of 41-39. This week they will be taking on the Malvern Prep Friars Saturday at 2 p.m. in what is sure to be a great game. Today in studio we have quarterback Kyle Shurmur with senior sports correspondent Carter Fillman. Carter?
What's up, LaSalle? Carter Fillman here with senior quarterback Kyle Shurmur. Currently you guys have a 2-1 record heading into Saturday's game. How are you feeling about the team's performance up to this point?
We played pretty well. Our young guys have really stepped up, and they're starting to play with confidence, and our seniors have been doing a nice job, and I feel like we're going to be pretty dangerous the rest of the year.
All right, coming off of a close win over DeMatha, 41-39, what is your team's mindset going into these big games against these tough opponents?
We got a lot of momentum going into this week. Last week was a really big win, and we're just planning on doing our thing again this week.
All right, this Saturday, you guys play Malvern Prep, 2 p.m. at Malvern. What is the team's preparation goals going into another game that will feature another tough offense?
Yeah, they have some really talented guys. Offense has to execute, and our defense just has to play hard, and I think we'll be okay.
All right, final question. What is the team's ultimate goal in your opinion?
We want to win a state championship. That's the ultimate goal. And then, obviously, to get there, we have to win the PCL championship and district championship. So, yeah.
All right, thanks, Kyle. Let's send it back to the desk.
Well, that's all we have for today, LaSalle. From myself, Carter, my director, Matt Mahoney, and the rest of the ever-so-lively WEXP crew, have a fantastic day. We'll leave you today with Comcast Sportsnet's feature on Kyle Shurmur and his father, the offensive coordinator of the Philadelphia Eagles. Tune in on Monday for a show featuring the new lab manager leaders as we delve into the wide world of technology.
Here on the Eagles practice field, offensive coordinator Pat Shurmur is preparing one of the most explosive offenses in football for its next contest. After spending most of the summer at the NovaCare Complex as one of the Eagles ball boys, Shurmur's son, Kyle, is now on his own practice field, preparing to lead LaSalle College High School's offense as its quarterback.
What is it like to have him at work with you when he has free time and the things that he can pick up just being out here?
Well, it's been outstanding. As a father, you like to spend time with your kids, and especially your sons. And so it's been fun for me. My whole career, he's been able to come to practice and be involved with what we do.
How they work and how they prepare for every single game. And I thought, you know, it was a privilege to be there, and I really loved just being around the office.
Shurmur will head to the SEC and Vanderbilt for football next year. But it's not just the gridiron where Kyle has done swimmingly. He's a state champion in the pool after helping the Explorers win their third straight team title in the spring. Another sport in his blood as his mom swam at Michigan State.
My mom, you know, she likes watching me play football, but she loves watching me swim, most importantly. So I feel like, you know, I'll continue football, but, you know, I'll enjoy swimming for one more year.
It's his time in the pool that's helped his transition to a new school and a more vocal role as the offensive leader.
I think he was comfortable with the school and with his environment with the swim team, because I heard stories back that he's messing around with them and a lot of jokes, practical jokes and things like that.
You hadn't seen that with the football team?
We did not see it with the football team, not the first couple months. So, you know, it just takes time for that to set in.
Last year I was new. Couldn't really, you know, raise my voice too much among these new guys I was just meeting. And this year I've been around a bunch of guys for, you know, over a year. And I feel like, you know, I know guys a little bit better, and I feel like we mesh a little bit better this year as opposed to last year.
Living up to being a coach's son isn't always easy, but Kyle's dad watches him play as a father would.
When we were having conversations about sports, it's always been father-son. And so most of the conversations we have are about all the things above the neck, you know, how you handle adversity, how you handle success.
You know, he knows when to leave football at the office and when to just be a father. And, you know, really, he doesn't really force football upon me at all. I think it's really cool, his job being an NFL coach, and I really take the initiative to talk to him about it. I just think it's, you know, it's awesome to have, you know, an NFL coach as your dad.
Marshall Harris, Comcast Sportsnet.